Though my children have been in fire, they will progress to the top if they obey what I tell them to do. This is just a transition to your promotion. Hallelujah. You are being tested and tried, but gold is on the other side. We're going to go more into this next on Prophetic Success. Hi, and welcome to Prophetic Success. I'm Kay Nash. On this show, we release prophetic words and deep teachings and trainings from the Word of God to help you succeed in life and walk Jesus towards your call in a deeper, more full way. Hallelujah. Now, let's jump into the Word. We've been talking a lot in 5780. Hallelujah. Whoo, Jesus. About the decade of fire. Now, we're already halfway through the year almost. And so I really want to talk about fire right now. We kind of alluded to that at the beginning of the month in February. We talked about, hallelujah. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Yah, that you are the consuming fire, God, that you are burning out everything that isn't you. Now, I really felt the Lord highlighting a couple things, Jesus. First of all, I felt like he was highlighting the story from Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to me. In the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the Bible, now this is in Daniel, Jesus. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused to bow down to an idol that Nebuchadnezzar wanted them to bow down to. And because of that, they're thrown into the fiery furnace. And I believe right now, many of you feel like you've been thrown into a fiery furnace. Specifically, many of you who are really following the Holy Spirit have felt like you've been thrown into a fiery furnace in the sense that you've been kicked out of churches. You've been kicked out of just positions in your job. You've been kicked out of all sorts of things, and you just feel like you're in a fiery furnace and you don't know where you belong and you don't know what's happening. And the interesting thing, this says, I think this is Daniel 3. It basically says in this place that their position was stripped from them. And so, you know, they were in a position already in the Proverbs of Babel. And so then, basically, Nebuchadnezzar takes them out of position and throws them into the furnace. And a lot of times, Jesus, you know, you might be taken out of position to be thrown into a furnace, you know. In my life, I was in a certain position, and God basically very drastically pulled me out of that position. And after he pulled me out of that position, for about 3 weeks, I was kind of not knowing what I'm supposed to do. But then the Lord told me to start this YouTube channel right here. And I see what God is, and I felt like the Lord is saying right now, don't get lost in the furnace, you know? Just because you're in a fire doesn't mean it's permanent. You know, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were in a fire, but then they came back up. Then they were promoted. You know, I think this is Daniel 3:30. Then the king promoted them in the Proverbs of Babel, and I believe that you're in a coming out season, Jesus, you know? It can be really hard in the furnace. It's hot in the furnace. It's hot in the furnace. You might be sweaty. You might just want to give up. But the angel of the Lord is coming to stir the pool of Bethesda around you, Jesus. You know, when the angel would come, he would stir the water where all the sick people were laying. The angel comes and grabs Jesus, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And the angels are coming to you right now to change you from the position you're in into the next position, to bring you to a higher position. You know, think about Jesus. After Jesus goes through the wilderness, Jesus, he comes out, and it says that the angels minister to him. The angels often come when you're in a transition season, when you're in a healing season, when you're in a moving season, when you're in a next level like season. Jesus, you know, you can get lost in the fire, but what do we say in our February word at the beginning of the month? Do not be consumed by the fire around you. And some of you are like, I'm going through the fire. Like something dramatic has happened in your life in this month. And I told you, do not be consumed by the fire. And because this is a test, okay? I really want you to hear what I'm saying. This is a test, okay, everybody? This is a test. 1 Peter 1:7. These trials will show, Jesus, that your faith is genuine. What does it say? These trials will show that your faith is genuine. So if you're going through trials, God might be testing your faith. It is being tested, as fire tests and purifies gold, Jesus. You know, God often puts us through these things to say, do you really believe this? Do you really, whew, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Do you really believe this? Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Do you really believe? Because you might be in a faith test, Jesus. It says you go through these trials to make sure that your faith is genuine. Sometimes, Jesus, God tells you something and you walk towards it and the opposite happens, or something horrible happens, or something tragic happens. But God wants to say, do you really believe what I told you in the secret place? Despite what you can see right now, despite what's going on right now, God is still going to move in your life. You're still going to get that house. You're still going to get that position. You're still going to move up in that company. Jesus, you're still going to raise children that follow the Lord despite the fact that they're not really following the Lord right now. God is still God, and what he said to you in secret will still happen. Do you believe your natural circumstances more than you believe God? How much do you trust what God told you over what you can see? What you can see has nothing to do with what God's going to do in your life. God could supernaturally turn everything around in your life, Jesus. And just in a moment, he can turn it around. Many of you know my story about, you know, I was asking for a certain promotion at my job, and they gave me the promotion, but they didn't give me the pay I wanted. Well, the contract was signed for a certain pay, but somebody higher up ripped the contract up and gave me that pay in Jesus' name. It doesn't matter what you see in the natural. It matters what he told you in the secret place. God had told me that number, so that number manifested. The biggest thing with your faith coming to pass is you actually knowing what God said. Because once you know what God says, it doesn't matter what's on the outside. God is going to move. You know, they could have got consumed by that fire. They could have stopped believing, but they said, our God will deliver us. Our God will deliver us. They knew something internally, despite what was going on outwardly. What do you know internally? Do you know that God will deliver you from this? How good is the God you serve? Will he not bring you out of the fire like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Because then it says in Daniel 3:30, ooh, Jesus, then the king promoted them in the province of Babylon. I believe right now we're in a promotion season. It's coming. It's coming. You're coming out of the fire. You're coming out of the fire. The angels are being sent. You're coming out of the fire. You're coming out of the furnace. And boom, there it is. There is your promotion. Your promotion is here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Your promotion is here. Do you believe by faith? Can you receive it by faith right now? I feel it dropping in the spirit. I feel mantles dropping in the field. I feel prophetic mantles, apostolic mantles, evangelistic mantles, pastoral mantles, ministry director mantles. Jesus. Whoo, Jesus, I feel a move of the Holy Ghost right now. Jesus, the mantles are falling. Hallelujah. Sorry, guys, the camera just died. Come back in now. Jesus, God, the mantles are falling. The promotion is coming. You're coming out of the fire, and you're being promoted into that next province. Whoo, into that next place, into that new position. Move forward in the Holy Ghost. You know, Deuteronomy 28:13, and Jehovah will make thee the head and not the tail. Thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath, if you hearken unto the commandments of Jehovah the God. And so I want to encourage you right now, just listen to what he's saying. When we started the video, we said, they will progress to the top as they obey what I tell them to. This is just a transition to your promotion. You are being tested and tried, but gold is on the other side. Hallelujah. Don't give up, guys. I know that the enemy is really throwing his hand right now. I can feel it in the spirit. And I just want to encourage you right now, Jesus. Go through the fire. The angel's going to bring you out. God is going to promote you. There's going to be another side. You know, I felt like many people have been battling a religious spirit right now. The religious spirit is very heavy right now. Oh, Jesus. And it's been kicking people out of church, kicking people out of jobs. Even some of your family members are religious, and they can't understand what you're going through right now. You know, the prophetic is offensive. If you have a prophetic anointing on your life, chances are it's offensive to people. And so I just want to encourage you to stay the course. Don't bow down to idols. Go where the Lord's telling you to go and do what he's saying. Another verse I felt like the Lord highlighting with all this was Isaiah 43. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the floods, that they, Jesus, will not overflow you. When you walk through the very fire, Jesus, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall thy flame kindle upon thee. And despite the fact that you're walking through the fire, you can stand on Isaiah 43. I felt that was our verse to kind of meditate on and really soak on for this week. Is just when you're going through the fire, you're going through the water, you just feel like there's a flood, you just feel like you're drowning, you feel like you're going to be burned. I just want to encourage you right now. You're not going to be burned by this. Jesus, it might feel like it, but you're not going to be burned by it. Okay? I felt like, you know, sometimes there's a conditional part of a prophecy, and what I feel like the conditional part of this prophecy is that we meditate on this verse, Isaiah 43. That's what I felt like that was part of the conditional part of this prophecy. And also, I felt like the Lord told me to emphasize again that fear, this is for someone right now, fear is a spirit, okay? It's a spirit. And we can bow to the spirit of fear and make the spirit of fear our God and say, I'm afraid, so I do this, versus listening to what the Holy Ghost is saying. You know, when you start following different fear over time, you start losing your sensitivity to the Holy Spirit because you just become consumed by a spirit of fear. You can't let a spirit of fear control you. Woo! You got to say, Holy Ghost, what are you saying? That's what I want to do. And walk forward in it in Jesus' name. All right, you guys, I wanted to talk to you again about France. I just wanted to say thank you so much to all of you who donated. We are over 18% right now in our donations to put on our two France conferences. For those of you that are new to this channel, we are putting on two free conferences in France, in Nice and Paris. We have already paid for the meeting rooms. We have the money for that. We have the money for the Nice Hotel. I did the wire transfer this week. And the money that you guys just gave me so far, I'm going to put that towards the Paris Hotel. So that will be paid for as well. And so right now we're just working on flights, my flight and my husband's flight to Nice, from Nice to Paris, and then Paris home. And so we need technically six flights that we need still. And so if you feel led to give into France, we're going to be equipping people to do heart healing. We're going to be equipping people to do deliverance, discerning of the spirits, prophetic. We're going to pray for the sick. And so if you want to help us put on those conferences in France, make sure you go to France on our tabs. Just go to knashministries.com, click on France. And everyone who gives over $200, we're doing a special brunch. It's going to be March 21st. You have to give by March 20th because we have to know who's coming, because we have to know how much food to buy and make sure. And so try to do that quickly if you feel led to come to this bruncheon. It's going to be a special private bruncheon March 21st in Central Florida. And but you have to give over $200 for that, but it's free for you to come into the France project. But if you can only give $5, we still appreciate that. We still value that. It's just the size of the room that we have. Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And also, if you want to come to be equipped, if you live in France or you live around France and you want to come, or you just happen to be in France, or you want to make a vacation of it and come out to France, the conferences are free in Nice and Paris. So I just love for you guys to come out there and get trained and equipped for God, because I really believe the Lord wants to move in France. Ooh, Jesus. There's firewalkers in France. Bonjour, my friends out there. I really believe some of you are going through something as well, and I want to equip you for the coming harvest of souls, Jesus. I'll see you next time on Prophetic Success. Bye, guys.